Hey guys, I welcome you all this week's episode. Just a quick brief word from me on the begin before we start with the lure. I did indeed promise last week that we're gonna finally do saltwater episode. I supposed to do some saltwater great lure. However, there is a winter in Poland, so I don't want to waste opportunity. There might be some chance for the ice fishing over the weekend, so actually what we're gonna do is ice fishing lure, as you probably find out from the thumbnail already. Anyhow, so it might be finally the first one built to catch if, as I say, the ice will be strong enough to go and fish on Saturday. If of course I will catch something, let alone for it to be just strong enough to step on it. Anyhow, without further ado, let's switch the camera pointed to my cutting mat and let's go with the ice fishing lure. Not one, but two. So okay guys, so two lures. One small one to be used for the perch, European perch, yellow perch, whichever way you want to call it. We go with 3.5 centimeters, and the second lure will be slightly bigger. It will be 6 centimeters. This one I'm hoping to use against pike, northern pike. This is the one that we have in Poland, Essox lucius. Having here my first gift from subscriber. These are lovely linden wood. It is very popular for carving lures in Poland. It is not very dense, slightly buoyant, but definitely harder and more dense than balsa wood. He sent me those lovely thin slices. We have 2 4 millimeters, which we're gonna use the 2/2 method to do this chunky guy. The really nice fine 2 millimeter thick slab of the wood which we're gonna use for the little guy. So let's trace it, the outlines of the lure on our pieces of wood, and we're gonna start shaping them with the usual 2/2 method as always. These two little slabs, I gonna now glue them together. Actually, first time I'm planning to use double side tape to glue the two halves together instead of the super glue. Let's see how that works for me. Will be the thickness of our lure, which is currently 4.2 mil. Let's trace the shape. Thank you. thinking how I should go about cutting out the shape, but I guess we're gonna go the usual copy saw as I'm using it always. Okay, happy with that shape. Little sanding right now, but let's go about and trace the second one off camera. And now the little guy. Is also very straight. So into the wire bending part. To think about the weightage of the lure, and I want to have it pretty much, if I have the line tie this spot, the bottom hook hanger in this spot, I need to add the weight on the equals both sides of the lure. So I'm thinking to go with the weight like so, and we're gonna actually remove it that much material and fill it all with the lead. Beautifully knit. Okay, so now I'm cutting the lead slot on the little lure, trying to do it as symmetrical as I possibly can. Anyway, putting it here, hammer it flat from one side, flipping it sideways, hammer it from the other side, and then I have it slightly square feet. Okay. And it sits nicely, almost flush. Super glue and baking soda to make it faster. I'm really tired, it's kinda late. I just want to go sleep. Again, I do shift tomorrow in the job, so go the quick way and then we'll see, guys. We'll see. I'm not promising that I might be able to finish both of the lures completely. I would love to, but we'll have to see about it. So, super glue baking soda to fill it in. That's why I prefer the filler, guys, because this, to be honest, is just disaster now. And it's so hard to send it. You need to use the file. It's really kind of annoying. That's why I like the filler. I'll just use the file. Okay guys, today is first day. This is how it looks. It's morning. I'm going actually for a few minutes to the basement before work. I'm trying to foil the little lure. The big one is already foiled. I'll continue in the basement. Copper tape. If you do it that way, look, I'll show you this lure compared to the bigger one. The scale pattern is slightly more regular than on the big one. Okay guys, so this is the final look of the lure. As you could probably hear, I'm actually in the train right now, coming back from the unsuccessful ice fishing trip. So in the end of the day, actually comes out that there was no ice strong enough to allow safe fishing. So there is not gonna be the fishing part of the video, so just showing you here how the lures turn out, the final view, and the rest of the video will include the paint portion. So if you want to skip that, you already know how to create them. So yeah, I will just say goodbye for now. Take care, and I see you next week. Bye. recognize the fact that I have the fluo orange in my chamber. I promised you yesterday we're gonna make the eyes for the lure. So stop talking, that will be quick montage on the speed up, but obviously I think it's self-explanatory. You will see how I'm doing my eyes. Gian Duiotti, whoever lives in Italy, just a quick tip, this is the best golden foil for the background of the realistic lure eyes. Thank you.